Hey guys, Ray from Love Your RV. Well, I just picked myself up a new crappy RV gadget. This is a 36-gallon tote tank for my waste. Now, why did I decide to get this at this time? Well, back in the fall, I purchased myself a macerator pump, mostly for pumping our waste tanks into my sister's sewer system at her house so that when we're staying and visiting, I could easily drain the tanks into her sewer system. So I hooked up that macerator pump and it worked really well. And now that I have the macerator pump, I'm able to pump uphill. So I thought now would be a good time to get a waste tote. So when we're boondocking, I can pump the waste out of our RV and up into the truck bed here where this thing will sit. Then I can drive the truck to the dump station and dump it. So let's get this out of the box and I'll show you why I actually chose this particular model, what features I liked about it that would be useful for me. There she is. So this is the Rhino tote tank. It's from Camco. I don't have anything to do with the company or anything. I bought this with my own money, my own choice. We'll go through the reasons I wanted it. One was I like these large wheels. If you do want to tow it behind the truck, it's good to have large wheels that can go over rough terrain. They also have bearings inside the wheels, and these are like solid wheels. Also, I wanted this feature, which I think is only available on their larger tanks. So you have a side access here, because basically I'm going to carry it in my truck and then hook the hose on and let gravity take it down into the sewer hole. They also have this output port here so that if you are on the ground you can just tip it up and pour it out the back. It's made in America. I think it has a two-year warranty. On the top here it has a tank, built-in tank rinser, and also a port for filling it from the top there. Pretty good size handle on the front. And then this is the tow bar, metal tow bar, hooks in like that. And then you can hook it up to your ball hitch on the back and tow it with the truck. Underneath there, you see this metal bracket here. That's for hanging on your ladder, which is where I'm gonna store mine. When I'm not using it, I'm gonna hang it on the RV ladder. And then they actually have these grooves in here so you can run ratchet straps through to strap it to your ladder so it's nice and secure that way. So I thought this was a pretty good one, and I went with the 36 gallon size, the biggest they have, because I have three waste tanks in my RV and they're all around 38 gallons. My fresh water is 60 gallons, so it kind of made sense to go with a bigger one like this. You know, if I fill up my fresh water, then two dumps of this will get rid of my waste. Anyway, also they got a bunch of doodads and attachments. Most of the stuff I probably won't use, but kind of nice that it came with it anyway. And so let's give you a demo of it. This is gonna be my first attempt with it myself. I'm gonna hook up my macerator to the sewer output of my RV and pump a load of waste up into here. I think I'm gonna start with my gray tanks first in case I made some kind of bad mistake. Okay, here we go, all set up. I won't go through how I set this up. I did a video on that before. It's a little convoluted because I actually have the Wastemaster hoses with the cam locks, so it's a little different system for me. Anyway, basically, I've got it hooked to the waste tank output. There's the macerator. I'm getting 12 volt power for it. It has actually a remote switch. This is a FlowJet model. Going through a hose that I use for it. It's a 3/4 inch hose. And then it's going into the actual tank rinser input, I think. I've just cracked this end just in case it needs to let air escape. I'm not really super familiar with this yet. Anyway, let's give her a try. Oh, I can hear it. seems to be doing the job. That's it. I think we just made it. I was able to look in the side here. Yeah, full tank. So got her all strapped in the back of the truck and we'll head to the dump station. Not too far, it's about a 4 mile drive. I'll take it easy. And then we'll see how this thing dumps. At the dump station now, got her all hooked up and ready to roll. Pretty fast actually, with that much distance. Dump number one complete. Now I'll go back for the black tank. A little bit nastier, just wanted to do the gray just to test everything out, make sure nothing's leaking in this thing, but so far everything's working great. Okay, so I went and filled up the tank again, this time with my black tank, and then came back to the dump station. Now I've dumped the black tank and now I'm just using the flusher to clean out the tank. And at the same time I'm cleaning out my macerator hose. And then at the same time I'm cleaning out my other wastemaster hose. So everything will be nice and clean. And then I brought the macerator just so I can give it a washout too. This thing up here has a built-in tank sprayer. Worked out pretty good. Put the old sewer hose back in place for the next dump when we move the trailer. You're probably asking, where are you going to put all this stuff? Where's the new tank going to go? Well, that's the reason I got it. It can go on the ladder. It's got the ladder hook. Then I got a few straps, ratchet straps to hold it in place. That's definitely not going anywhere. It's solid. And the rest of it, this is the macerator pump. So I cleaned it all up and it goes back in its little case that it came in. Then I've got a sewer case for all my connections and stuff like that, and my sewer ramp. And then these pieces will just go back and get put in the steel toolbox at the front there. Everything has a place. Well, I think that's gonna work out pretty good as long as it's durable and doesn't leak. First day testing it, came out a success, no leaks, and got rid of all my gray and black water today. Now I can go and use my water bladder and bring in some more fresh water. So between the water bladder and this, we won't really have to leave a campsite for an extended time if we feel like it, which is kind of what I wanted to do when we go back to British Columbia is explore some of the more forested campsites, but there are oftentimes half hour down a pretty windy road with no dump station. So it's going to be handy to be able to just load this into the truck and go dump our waste and pick up some water and just leave the Cougar all set up to camp. Anyway, I'll come back with a review on it at a later date after I've used it for a while, let you know how it goes. If anybody has any advice on using these, feel free to leave them in the comments and educate all us newbies that haven't used one of these before. Anyway, now I can go have a nice long shower and get ready for a happy hour sunset. Till next time, Ray from loveyourrv.com. Cheers, everyone.